Mr. Speaker, that minister's disdain for some of the most vulnerable people in our society is on full view today, and it's not a pretty sight, Mr. Speaker. First, he refused to accept when the federal court ruled his actions were unconstitutional. Then he continued his attack by using the omnibus budget bill to sneak changes that would take social assistance away from refugees. Now he's refusing to fully respect the court's decision on refugee health care. What does this minister have against refugees?
The Honourable Minister of Immigration.
Well, Mr. Speaker, there he goes again. Does the member opposite have any respect either for Canadians or for the English language? Because there is no case, Mr. Speaker, when refugees, those determined to be so by our independent Immigration and Refugee Board or by the UNHCR and then resettled to Canada, has failed to receive health care under this government. And they will continue, refugees, to receive health care. What the NDP is asking for, Mr. Speaker, and we really prove it unbelievable, is that people whose claims were found to be false, people whose claims were found to be fraudulent, people who are waiting to be removed from Canada should receive better health care than Canadians themselves.
The Honourable Member from Davenport.
That's wrong, wrong, and wrong, Mr. Speaker. The Federal Court and the Federal Court of Appeal could not have been more clear. Conservatives' treatment of refugees was deemed inequitable, unconstitutional, and yes, causing refugees harm, Mr. Speaker, but instead of fully restoring the interim federal health program, the minister is playing politics, deciding some people get it and some people don't. Why won't he just respect the court's decision and restore health care to refugees? Yeah.
The Honourable Minister of Immigration.
Refugee health care has been in place all along. It remains in place. Even the member for Markham Unionville gets that, Mr. Speaker, as he said yesterday. The federal court gets that. If you read their decision, they understand that the issues they were pronouncing upon relate to claimants, not to those whose claims have been found to be legitimate and have refugee status. Mr. Speaker, the honourable member should stand in this House, acknowledge that he has been misleading Canadians, acknowledge that he is asking for better health care for fraudulent claimants, for failed claimants, for those who are about to leave Canada, Mr. Speaker. We don't think that's appropriate.